Hi, I'm Danny at Danny's Do-It-Yourself Garage. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll be going over some common air conditioner problems on my 2009 Honda Civic. My air conditioner on a 97 degree day is blowing 75 degrees out the vents, and that's unacceptable. I figure if I'm having problems with my AC, you're probably having problems with yours also. In today's video, I'll go over some possible causes for lack of cooling. Hopefully this helps you on your air conditioner issues and helps me diagnose my AC system too. Let's get started by first checking the control head for some diagnostic codes. No scan tool is necessary to perform this test. So I'm going to start by checking to see if there's any codes in the control head. One of the reasons I'm starting here is because it's a simple check to do. So what I'll do is I'll hold the recirc button and the rear defogger down while I turn on the key. And then on the recirc button, it'll flash codes if there's any codes there. It's going to go through a couple of cycles. You'll hear the blower motor go on. So let's go ahead and give that a shot right now. I'm going to put the key in, and then I'm going to hold the rear defogger and the recirc button down, and I'll turn the key on. AC light came on. Blower motor just turned on, and this light turned on, but it's not flashing. Blower motor went to low. Everything turned off, and there's no codes flashing. My control head had no codes in it. All right, our next step is also a pretty basic step. Turn the fan on. And we just want to go through the modes. Right now, we're getting air right here on the top. Now we're getting air on the bottom and the top. Now it's all on the floor. So we just needed to know every mode is working here. So we checked our AC system.
Next, I'll move the temperature control knob from hot to cold. That should move the actuator blend door. The blend door determines the amount of airflow that goes through either the heater core for hot air or the evaporator for cold air. If this sticks or doesn't work properly, this could be your problem. I'll check that now.
Okay, we're gonna take the temperature control knob and turn it all the way to hot and watch the actuator. It should go nice and smooth. Now let's go to the cold position and watch it to make sure it doesn't bind. Everything's nice and smooth. Let's go back to hot. Looks good. Let's go halfway and then go the other halfway. All right, so my knob and control head and actuator, everything looks fine here. Let's go on to our next step.
So our next step, we want to turn on the AC system and see if both those fans come on.
We'll go ahead and turn it off and on a couple of times.
At this point, my fans, control head, and actuators are all working properly. I'll do a visual inspection next. What I'm looking for is anything obvious or any oil residue, because when Freon leaks, it loses oil, and this is what you'll see left behind. Sometimes dye can be added to help find the leak, but you'll need to use a black light. But for now, let's look the system over and see what we can find. Look at the hoses and where they connect to make sure there isn't any oil on those lines. Go down to the compressor clutch down here and look to make sure that compressor clutch isn't blown apart. I've seen that before. And then also there's a little pressure sensor right here. Make sure the wires don't have oil on it or they're not eaten away by a rat. I've seen that before. And then the back of the compressor where everything connects, make sure there's no oil there. And then go inside the vehicle here and kind of look at that area. That's where the evaporator is. And then also go underneath the vehicle and look around at the condenser to make sure you don't see a bunch of oil and those fins aren't smashed or something didn't hit your condenser. So just do a nice visual inspection. And once you see everything is okay, then we'll go on to our next step. Now, if your compressor clutch isn't engaging, there is a few common problems I've seen. The AC relay is one of them. Let me show you. Now, another common problem when your AC compressor doesn't turn on, it's going to be the AC relay. And the easiest way to check that is to pull out the radiator fan and then swap it with the AC compressor relay and see if it turns on. Listen. It works. The next one is less common, although I feel like I should mention it. There is an air gap between the compressor and the compressor clutch. And I've seen this wear, causing the compressor clutch not to engage. Here's how I check it. Although I do not recommend you doing it this way, it's dangerous. This is just the way I do it.
So if your compressor doesn't even turn on, it could be the clutch is wearing out. Now I don't recommend doing this, but this would be one scenario. Just reach a screwdriver down in here. And like I say, I don't recommend doing this. And then just put a little pressure on it. And if it engages like that, then it needs a clutch.
There's also a pressure switch that'll cause the compressor not to come on. That'll also cause the fan not to come on. So just make sure that pressure switch, the wires are okay, and the switch is okay. So I'm gonna plug this one in, and then I'll recycle the key and everything should turn off. The most common reason for an AC compressor not to come on or blow warm air is your system is low on Freon. To check this, I purchased a can of Freon from the parts store with a hose. I'll be adding some Freon to see if my temperature drops as I add the Freon. I'll also be using the PowerProbe wireless temp kit to help me determine this. This will monitor the temperature of the air coming out the vent while I add Freon to see if the temperature will drop. All right, so it's a little noisy here. Hopefully you can hear me. I've got my temperature gauge. It's 91 degrees here, and this is reading this sensor. So this is outside air temperature. And then inside the car, right outside the air vent, it's 75 degrees there. So I'm gonna go ahead and take off the cap. And I'll take my can here, and I just wanna put my hose on here. All right, and then we're going to take this. Oop. And just plug it in. Okay. But let's look at our temperature. We're at 74 right now. I'm going to add some Freon in there in the low side. Now let's let it stabilize. And hopefully this is going to come down a little bit. Let's go ahead and add some more here.
On my car, adding Freon made no difference whatsoever, and I determined I needed to replace my expansion valve. I have a video on how to replace the expansion valve. I'll link it at the end of the video, but for now, let's hook up a set of gauges and see what my pressures and temperature looks like after replacing the expansion valve. Now, if you had to replace a component like the evaporator, you'll have to add some PAG oil. Consult your service manual for the correct specifications. I hope you learned something in today's video. If you did, give me a thumbs up, consider subscribing, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.